These trees and trails nurtured Atlanta's black middle class a few years ago. Home to Andy Young and Martin Luther King Jr., the historic West Side was the segregated heart of a growing city. A ball player from the Negro League brought up his children here.
I'm part of that middle class that grew up in this area and then would go on to better things.
The baseball field is named for Chico Renfro, a familiar voice for generations who heard the former baseball player broadcasting sports on AM radio. Chico Renfro's son, Othello, says his father's career was born in that segregated era.
My father was a postman for 14 years, and this was the best job a black man could have to raise his family in the middle class. He would come home, turn on the sports program, and there would be ball games of a white high school player that would score the winning touchdown, the interception. And he said, what about the black kid that did the same thing? Who's talking for them? My father went out, bought a tape recorder, put in his retirement papers at the post office, and start going around to all the high schools, interviewing these kids, getting them on his show. He had an AM radio show called WIGO Radio. It was AM during that time. He would interview these kids. He would write articles in the Atlanta World, go to his high school, take pictures, give them awards.
Even today, almost 30 years after his father died, Chico Renfro's son hears from the next generation.
There'll be children that say, my father, my mother used to listen to your father on the radio. And they remember my father.
And they remember Washington Park. Like all Atlanta parks now legally integrated, yet home to a bitter and sweet heritage. Sally Sears, CBS 46 News.